I want to talk to you guys today about crackers and cheese. Now, I read this story a long time ago, and it had a deep, deep impact on me. Now, I can't tell you 100% if this story is correct. It supposedly happened in the 1920s. I read about it in a Napoleon Hill book. So, who knows? But I still think it's an impactful story. This gentleman wanted to go see Napoleon Hill, thinking grow rich, on a cruise. And back then, they used to do a lot of trainings on cruise ships. So people would book passage onto the cruise. They'd see a couple speakers. I mean, it's still kind of common now, to be honest. I mean, I still see a lot of speakers that, you know, book cruise ships. And then I think Oprah did one last year. And I can't think of, ask what's his face. I can't think of it. Does it quite often, too. And this gentleman wanted to see all the greats. It was Napoleon Hill, Rockefeller, just all the greats. But he didn't have money. He wasn't making good money at the time. But he just knew he had to go see it. So he booked the cheapest fare he could find. I mean, it was where you stayed at the bottom of the ship, you know, where all the luggage was. But he got on the ship. So he went, it was like a 7-day cruise. He went to every session. He had his notebook, his pencils. And then when the meals came, breakfast, lunch, and dinner, he would go back to his room. And because he didn't have money, he really wanted to save what little money he had so he could purchase some programs. So he packed 7 days worth of crackers and cheese. So breakfast, lunch, and dinner, he would go back to his little storage area. He would eat his crackers and cheese, and then he'd be right back on time for the next session. And this went on for 7 days. He made great relationships, made fantastic contacts. On the last day, one of the gentlemen he was sitting next to, they were talking about the big dinner at the end, that, you know, all the greats are going to be there, and you got to sit with one of the greats at your table. And I mean, it was the buzz of the room. And the guy sitting next to him said, "Are you coming to the event? Because, you know, we could sit at the same table together." And the gentleman's like, no, I didn't. Finally, he confesses and said, "I didn't get that as part of my package." And the guy looked at him and said, "The meals were included." He settled. He didn't even inquire. He never thought to ask, "Hey, what do I get with this?" He assumed, because it was the cheapest thing, that he would settle for crackers and cheese. You never know what you're going to get until you ask. People always tease me because I will always ask, what else? What if? You know, it doesn't matter what you hand me. It's going to be, well, would you like, or can I, or... And they're always like, well, you want more. It's not that I want more. I'm just not willing to settle. And I see too damn many people willing to settle, willing to take what they get and not ask for more. And you'd be amazed when you asked a question, well, do you think I can go? You know, do you think I can be invited? I mean, when we started Arizona Alpha 20-some years ago, I was a wingman. My boss at the time, Sherry Scott, was going to go. And, you know, she really didn't want to take the drive by herself. And I was like, can I go? I mean, I've been kind of reading about this new assisted living thing. Can I go? And she's like, sure, you can go. And look what it led to. I can't tell you how many times I've done what people would perceive, invite myself. Do you think I could go to the event? Do you think I can get a ticket? Do you really think it's sold out? You know, I've called people that I know that have tickets and said, hey, I know you have tickets to this event. Do you know anybody that wants to dump their ticket off, or whatever it is? Because you don't know. You know, I can't tell how many people I've reached out to. You know, the big names, you know, the Amy Porterfields and Marie Forleo's, the people I've reached out to personally and said, you know, I see what you're saying, but I'm not sure I understand this little piece. What do you think? And you'd be amazed at people that, how many of them are willing to say, hey, well, you know, let me jump on the phone with you for 10 minutes. Or, you know, write your question down and I'll answer the email, you know, over the weekend or whenever. If you're willing to ask, the universe will open up for you. If you're willing to believe in yourself and place your bets on you, the universe will completely and totally deliver for you. But if you're willing to settle and accept what's given to you, then you may always be at the end of the line. You may always be, what's the saying, a day late and a dollar short. Believe in yourself. Know what you want and go after it. If you see somebody, I mean, I can't tell how many people reach out to me and say, hey, you know, I see that you're really good at, you know, doing videos. I see you're really good at networking. You're really good at building tribes. Can you help me? And I will always say yes, always. Now, there are people that, you know, cross the line, and when you're not willing to settle, you have to know, you have to kind of know where the line is. And that took me a long time to understand, because I would just keep asking because people would keep giving. And then I realized I was taking advantage of them. So you got to kind of know what you want, explain it at the get, and then when, after you get it, go. I can't tell you how many lunches I've gone to sit with people, or, you know, kind of now because my time has become so, you know, shrunk, you know, how many times I've gone for a cup of coffee, although I always laugh because I don't drink coffee, you know, but I've gotten to sit for a cup of coffee with somebody and give them a half hour and just kind of help them. You don't know until you ask, and don't accept. Don't accept the answer until you're sure that's the final answer, you know, because you don't know. You don't know who's sitting on those, you know, I went to when the All-Star game was in town. I ended up going, I had great tickets. I had tickets last year right behind home plate where they pitched the ball. Pitchers are not, I'm gonna tell you, their seats are not all that. I mean, they look cool on TV to be able to sit right there and watch all the pitches. First of all, you can't eat because you're on screen, so you have to wait till the catcher throws the ball back so you can eat. You're not allowed to stand except for these certain, I mean, there's so many rules there, it's just amazing. But free food, free drinks, can't beat that. I asked somebody like a year and a half ago, you know, does anybody know what it costs to sit there? And how do you get tickets? Because it's, you know, pretty much back then sold out. And everybody's like, no, not really. No, the clear blue, I get tickets. You know, so he calls me and says, hey, I got tickets, you know, for behind the home plate. I heard you're interested. Do you want them? And I'm like, absolutely. How much? And they're like, oh, no, no worries. You know, someday you might give me, you know, we might be able to pay back or pay it forward. You don't know until you ask. Don't settle for the crackers and the cheese. Settle for the steak. Settle for the lobster. Always ask people, can I go? You know, what will it take? How can I get that? Because you'd be amazed how many people are willing to give. I had tickets to the Phoenix All-Star game. I started talking about that and then I stopped. I gave them away. Somebody I know called and said, hey, I hear you have tickets to the All-Star game. And I'm like, yeah, I got, you know, four tickets. And she's like, are you going to use all four? What do you want to do with them? And I said, well, to be honest, I don't want to go. Somebody gave them to me and I didn't want to tell them no, but I don't want to go. So if you want four tickets, come get them. And she enjoyed the game way more than I ever would have because she had two kids that were just begging to go to the All-Star game. You know, and like 6 months after that, she called me and said, hey, you know, I've got some, you know, I can get you a tea time at this one private course if you want to go. And I'm like, hell yeah, I'll go. So, I mean, people just pay back. But if you don't want to do something and you have it, give it away. But if you know somebody has something and they don't want it, ask. You just don't know. You just, you know, I've told you guys the story of, I went and asked when we first started Arizona Alpha, they sent me to go ask this woman, I won't say her name, but she's a billionaire. Swear to God, billionaire. And they sent me to ask her for sponsorship. And I came back and I was so excited because I got $500 off her. I was so excited. And that's when my mentor looked at me and said, do you know who she is? And I said, yeah. And I said, you know, you need to go Google her, Karen, because you didn't do your research. And I Googled it and I was like, shh, are you effing kidding me? How'd I miss that one? So I went back. You never know until you ask. I went back and knocked on her door and said, hey, you know I asked you for 500, but the sponsorship is really 5,000 if you went to the overarching. And we had, the big sponsorship. And I think your company would be better positioned there. She wrote me a check right there on the spot and said, that was the sponsorship I wanted, but you weren't selling me on it, so I wasn't going to ask. You never know until you ask. So don't settle for crackers and cheese, y'all. Ask. Go after what you want. Know what you want and go after with fierce determination. Because the universe will move mountains. The gods will do whatever it takes to get you what you want. Got to know what you want. You can't waffle. And please, 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 please don't settle. Thanks a lot, you guys. Have a great Monday. Stay safe out there. Mask up. Keep your hands sanitized. And we will get out of this. Talk to you guys later. Have a great Monday. Bye-bye.